Today's video is going to discuss Chapter 3.5, Arithmetic Sequences as Linear Functions. So today what we're going to focus on, essentially, is the concept of patterns. And so the idea is that if it is an arithmetic sequence, then you should be able to see a pattern between each of these terms. So to get from the first term to the second term, negative 4 to negative 2, I have to add 2. To get from negative 2 to 0, the second term to the third term, I add 2. To get from the third term to the fourth term, I add 2. Since each of these is adding 2, the answer to this one is yes, it is an arithmetic sequence. Now, if you look at this bottom one, the easiest way to do this is probably turn these all into common denominators so I can kind of see if there's a common difference. So this would be 8 sixteenths, 10 sixteenths, 12 sixteenths, and then obviously this one is still 13 sixteenths. And so to get from the first term to the second term, the common difference is, or I guess the difference is adding 2 sixteenths. To get from the second term to the third term, I'm adding 2 sixteenths. However, to get from the third term to the fourth term, I'm only adding 1 sixteenth. Since this is not a common difference, the answer here is no, it is not an arithmetic sequence. So in order for it to be an arithmetic sequence, it has to have a common difference. So the next idea is trying to figure out what would the next three terms be. So to get from 15, the first term, to the second term, which is 9, I'm going to subtract 6. To get from the second term to the third term, I also subtract 6. And the third term to the fourth term, I subtract 6. Now the question is, what are the next three terms? So I'm looking for now the fifth, sixth, and seventh term. So if I'm subtracting 6, I got to go negative 3 minus 6. That's going to give me negative 9. That would be my fifth term. I would then need to subtract 6 again to get to my sixth term. And then I would need to subtract 6 again to get to my seventh term. So these would be my fifth, sixth, and seventh terms. Now I'm intentionally using the idea of terms because that's going to bring us to this formula, which you see on the top of this board. And so I want to quickly kind of go over what each of these is. But a to the n, n is the number term, a is the value of the arithmetic sequence. And so this is the value of the first term. Again, n stands for the term. You're going to subtract 1 from that in this particular parentheses, and then d is the common difference. So for example, in that last problem, the common difference was negative 6. So if you look at this particular problem, to get from the first term to the second term, and then from the second term to the third, and the third to the fourth, what I'm doing is I'm adding 4 each time. So 4 is going to be my common difference. So I could rewrite this as a to the n equals the value of the first term, this is my first term, negative 12 plus n minus 1 times 4, which is my common difference. Now what I need to do is distribute. So this is going to become negative 12 plus 4n minus 4, and then I can put these two together, right? I can combine like terms, and this is going to become negative 16 plus 4n. So this would be the formula to find the nth term of this arithmetic sequence. Now the idea is that then I can substitute the number term into this part of the equation and I can solve for anything that I would want. So for example, the fifth term, right? First term, second term, third term, fourth term, the fifth term is going to be 4 because I would just add 4. And the sixth term would be 8. So if I were to take 5 for the fifth term and put it in here, 5 times 4 is 20. 20 plus negative 16 is 4. There's my fifth term. To find the sixth term, I could take 6, substitute it in here. 6 times 4 is 24. Negative 16 plus 24 is positive 8. There's my sixth term. Now, this might not be the fastest way to try to find the fifth and sixth term, but if I wanted to find the 17th term, it might be faster to figure out all this and then substitute 17. It certainly would be faster if I wanted to find the 84th term. You're not going to keep drawing this all the way out to 84 times. The 1,334th term would be faster to use this formula as opposed to drawing this out 1,034 times. So that's the advantage of using this formula. The other thing I want you to see, and this is a shortcut that some people like to use, is that this formula can actually be derived a different way. I mean, it's using the same idea, but if I think of this as the first term, the term that comes before it would be term zero. And so this is actually term zero, right? Because if these are going up by four to go backwards, I would have to go down by four. So I could subtract four, subtract four, subtract four, subtract four more. This would take me to negative 16. That's this. And then 4n is just the difference. So it's term zero, and then the difference times n. I'm going to show you how that works again. We're going to practice one more. So keep in mind, we're going to use this formula. So you may want to pause the video now to write down this formula if you don't currently have it written down. So we're going to use that formula now to solve this problem. So we want to find the nth term in this sequence. So if you look at this, we got to first figure out what is the common difference. So the common difference here, hopefully we see, is 3. So we're going to take a to the n equals the first term, which is 2, plus n minus 1 times 3. So this is 2 plus, I'm going to distribute, this becomes 3n minus 3. Now what I want to do is combine like terms. So you know 2 and negative 3 can go together. And so that is going to be negative 1 plus 3n. Now, if I wanted to find the way that you can check yourself or check your answer is I know the fourth and fifth term are going to be very easy for me to figure out, right? Because I can just add 3. So the fifth term is this. And I'm sorry, the fifth and sixth term. And the sixth term is that. So what I can do is I can substitute 5 in here. 5 times 3 is 15, plus negative 1 is 14, and then 6. 3 times 6 is 18, negative 1 plus 18, 17. So I know that if it works for all of these, most likely I've got myself a winner. The other thing, if you remember the shortcut, is I would take, since I'm going up by 3, as I move this way, this direction I'm going down by 3, so term 0 is going to be negative 1, and the common difference is 3. So it's going to be the first term 0, and then the common difference. Now, keep in mind, so these say the same thing. Now, keep in mind, if these numbers were going down, your common difference could be negative, turning this number negative, meaning you have to multiply by a negative number. All right, that's all we got for arithmetic sequences as linear functions. Thank you for watching this video. Do not forget to answer the questions at the bottom of this page. I'll see you in class.